As this season of Lent draws to a close, we turn to the passion of Jesus, his command and eventual desertion of those closest to him. This is a season when we take a good look at ourselves to see where Jesus lives and where we do not allow Jesus access. Today and every day, we turn to Jesus so that we can be transformed and filled with the living presence of God more fully.
Just receive will welcome, pardon, cleanse, relieve, because thy promise I believe. O Lamb of God, I come. Just as I am, thy love unknown has broken every barrier down. Now to be thine, yea, thine alone, O Lamb of God, I come, I come.
Friends in Christ, in this Lenten season, we sampled images and stories of hope. We know that the ways of the world give us a false sense of hope. So together, we have nurtured our faith through stories that draw us to God's love and grace, which gives us hope even in the wilderness times of our lives. Within the community of the church, God never wearies of forgiving sin and giving the peace of reconciliation and an abundance of new possibilities. Today, we turn again to God, confessing our inclination to seek hope and goodness of our own making rather than the grace and mercy of God. When we repent, God, who is both faithful and just and merciful, will welcome us back and renew our hope for what is yet to come. Please join me in confession. Merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin and made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with the power of the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Eternal God, in the sharing of a meal, your Son established a new covenant for all people. In the washing of feet, he showed us the dignity of service. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these signs of our life and faith may speak again in our hearts. Feed our spirits and refresh our bodies. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Oh. A reading from Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall be marked for you and for the beginning of the months. It shall be the first month of the year for you. Tell the whole congregation of Israel that on the 10th of this month, they are to take a lamb for each family, a lamb for each household. If a household is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join its closest neighbor in obtaining one. The lamb shall be divided in proportions to the number of people who eat of it. Your lamb shall be without blemish, a year old male. You may take it from the sheep or from the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. Then the whole assembled congregation of Israel shall slaughter it at twilight. They shall take some of the blood and put it on the two doorposts and the lintel of the houses in which they eat it. They shall eat the lamb that same night. They shall eat it roasted over the fire with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. Do not eat any of it raw or boiled in water, but roasted over the fire, with its head, legs, and inner organs. You shall let none of it remain until the morning. Anything that remains until morning you shall burn. This is how you shall eat it: your loins girded, your sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand. And you shall eat it hurriedly. It is the Passover of the Lord. For I will pass through the land of Egypt that night, and I will strike down every firstborn in the land of Egypt, both human beings and animals. On all the gods of Egypt I will execute judgments. I am the Lord. The blood shall be a sign for you on the houses where you live. When you see the blood, I will pass over you, and no plague shall destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt. This day shall be a day of remembrance for you. You shall consecrate it as a festival to the Lord. Throughout your generations, you shall observe it as a perpetual ordinance." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We join in reading responsively selected verses of Psalm 116. I love the Lord who has heard my voice and listened to my supplication. For the Lord has given ear to me whenever I called. How shall I repay the Lord for all the good things God has done for me? I will lift up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all God's people. Precious in your sight, O Lord, is the death of your servants. O Lord, truly I am your servant. I am your servant, the child of your handmaid. You have freed me from my bonds. I will offer you the sacrifice of thanksgiving and call upon the name of the Lord. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all God's people, in the courts of the Lord's house, in the midst of you, O Jerusalem.
Merciful and kind, slow to anger, rich in blessing, and with love to us inclined.
The Holy Gospel according to the 13th chapter of St. John. Glory to you, O Lord. Now before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and to go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put into the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I am doing, but later you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was to betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet, had put on his robe, and had returned to the table, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example that you also should do as I have done to you. Very truly, I tell you, servants are not greater than their master, nor are messengers greater than the one who sent them. If you know these things, you are blessed if you do them. Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and will glorify him at once. Little children,
I am with you only a little longer. You will look for me. And as I have said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should have love for one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. This is the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Grace, mercy, and peace be to you, from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. This is a new command, that you love one another just as I have loved you. To have love for one another. What are the examples in your life where people have witnessed an act of kindness or generosity or compassion or genuine love for one another? To have love for one another, in the understanding in the Greek terminology, is to have agape, to have this kind of love that St. Paul describes in his letter to the Corinthians, to put down one's life for the sake of one's friends, says Jesus, to be empathetic with one another, to walk in the other person's shoes, so to speak. This is what Jesus was doing with his disciples, is that he was taking on the role of a servant, and in so doing, he took off his outer robe, tied a towel around himself, and then one by one and foot by foot, calling forth these disciples, these ones that had been with him from the beginning, as he called them forth to come and follow me, as they had experienced Jesus doing some miraculous things, things that they couldn't even explain, feeding people by the thousands with just a small fraction of what was necessary. Walking on water, calming the storms. But what Jesus now tells his disciples to do is to observe his behavior and to act in that way, to have love for one another. Do you think that Jesus was anticipating a time when these disciples may not be in full agreement with each other? Times in life that are challenging and hard, and people come at it from different perspectives and ways of thinking, but to ground their life and center it in this act of humility, in this act of compassion, in this act of servanthood, would be that which would be foundational for their lives. So that even when life is hard, even when life is difficult, even when life is uncertain, even when we do not have the answers that we desire, even when we see each other through different sets of lenses, and we do not see eye to eye on things. Jesus says, I give you a new commandment, that you love like this. To be willing to let go of our ways of thinking that we are superior to others, that we have all the answers, that our way is best, but to learn to be servants for the sake of the other. And so as these disciples came forth, they would have experienced their Lord and their teacher taking on the role of a servant, washing their feet, drying them with a towel, and then getting up from the table, meeting them again at this place where they had shared a meal together, telling them that they had just experienced what he desired them to do for each other. To take that towel of servanthood and to take that up in acts of kindness and empathy for one another. As we meet together today on this Maundy Thursday, it's a new commandment, is the terminology of Maundy means. A new commandment that I give to you. The mandate is to love one another as Jesus loves us. This prepares our hearts for the road that's yet to come. It was to prepare the disciples for a time when all would seek their own ways and run in fear for the sake of their own lives and hide behind locked doors for fear that they might be next. But on this holy day, we turn first to the command of Jesus, where we are willingly looking each other in the eye, through the eyes of Jesus, to see each other as Jesus first sees us, as caretakers and servants, one with the other. May we love each other with that kind of compassion, and may we serve each other with that kind of commitment. Not so that others see our goodness, but that the revelation of Jesus in his love for the sake of the world might be revealed through us. We love because Jesus first loved us. May that bear witness in our lives, so that others know that kind of love for the sake of the world, willing to die and rise for you. Amen.
Love consecrates the humblest act and hallows mercy's deeds. It sheds a benediction sweet and hallows human needs. When in the shadow of the cross Christ knelt and washed the feet of his disciples, he gave us a sign of love complete. Love stirs and willing stoops to serve what Christ in love so true has freely done for one and all. Let us so gladly.
United by the servant love of God in Christ Jesus, we pray for the needs of the whole world. You call your people to hand on what we receive from you. Form all the baptized into teachers of faith. From one generation to the next, give your church hunger for your promises in the sacraments and joy in receiving and sharing your word. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Your creation provides all we need. Cleanse and protect the resources you have given so that there is enough for all. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. You redeemed your people from slavery. Preserve people throughout the world who flee violence and oppression. Establish just leadership in place of tyranny and peace in place of war. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Jesus loved his followers to the end. Grant assurance that love to all who need it. Those living with guilt, those struggling to forgive, those who are lonely or overlooked. Heal the sick and embrace the dying. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Jesus washed the feet of the one who betrayed him. Inspire this congregation's ministries of service that we love as Jesus loved us. Give us renewed courage to serve. Bless the ministry of all servants throughout the church. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Your glory shone in the suffering, death, and resurrection of Jesus. We thank you for generations of the faithful who have proclaimed our Lord's death. Unite us with them in hope until he comes again. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Hear these and all our prayers, O God, in the name of the one who loves us to the end. Jesus Christ, our Redeemer. Amen. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love. In your great compassion, blot out my offenses. Wash me through and through from my wickedness and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my offenses, and my sin is ever before me. Against you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight. So you are justified when you speak and write in your judgment. Indeed, I was born steeped in wickedness, a sinner from my mother's womb. Indeed, you delight in truth deep within me, and would have me know wisdom deep within. Remove my sins with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be purer than snow. Let me hear joy and gladness, that the body you have broken may rejoice. Hide your face from my sins, and blot out all my wickedness. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and sustain me with your bountiful spirit. Let me teach your ways to offenders, and sinners shall be restored to you. Rescue me from bloodshed, O God, of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing of your righteousness. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise. For you take no delight in sacrifice, or I would give it. You are not pleased with burnt offering. The sacrifice of God is a troubled spirit. A troubled and broken heart, O God, you will not despise. Favor Zion with your good pleasure. Build up the walls of Jerusalem. Then you will delight in the appointed sacrifices, in burnt and whole offerings. Then young bulls shall be offered upon your altar.